Hey, Teresa.
Hi, how are you?
I'm really good.
So
how
nice
are you?
To see you.
I'm Guillermo Diaz. I'm an actor. I'm currently on a TV show called Scandal.
I think this is the most awesome place I've ever been to in
my
life.
You see our robot? Look at our robot.
I know, that kind of looks like Larry in the morning.
We're here in my home in Los Angeles, and we're here with my partner Mike and his sister Kim.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Nice to see you too.
This is amazing.
Yeah.
And I consider it a privilege to be able to, you know, reconnect people with their loved ones. So
thank you so much. We're so excited. I do believe in mediums. I believe there's people out there that can, you know, communicate with people that have passed on. And I've always been fascinated by it. And I'm looking forward to hanging out with Teresa.
So, as I give my speech to you, that is my sign to your loved ones that I am ready to work. I only ask for good things, so if you feel that your loved ones bring up something negative, it is to help us release those negative emotions.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Right now there is a struggle of a spirit coming through, but there was a mother and father energy that stepped forward and they held hands. So where did the parents come in?
Both of our parents.
Both of your parents are departed?
Yeah.
So know that they're stepping forward, and the reason why they're stepping forward first is because they want to thank you. Because they made me feel like you did this for them.
Yeah.
So they're gonna be the spirit hogs.
I know.
Do you see? I try.
That's what I wanted.
And that's amazing.
Yeah. It is.
So do you remember your parents? Well, I don't know what parents don't bicker. I mean, you know, but it's almost like your father went to say something and your mom's like, could you just wait a minute? Teresa's talking. Like, I feel like your mother doesn't want him to talk. Like,
totally.
She doesn't want him to screw
it up. Totally.
And I'm like, you can't screw it up. It's going to be fine.
Yeah, absolutely. That's totally the dynamic of the personalities. Yeah.
Where did you grow up? They moved me to, like, another place. Like, I feel like, I don't know, like if I live in the cheese country.
Cache Valley, Utah. Yeah,
what's that?
They make cheese there.
They make cheese in Cache Valley.
It started as a cow town where they made cheese.
And we come from cow country.
Yep.
It's made in Cache Valley.
Oh my God, yeah.
Totally, yeah.
Yeah. Our parents were so fulfilling and so engaged in my life. My mother was an amazing woman. In our neighborhood and community, she was talked about as an angel out to help everyone else. She was a charitable, benevolent, amazing mom.
I don't even know how to quantify or explain how my father and I were so close. I was fairly tomboyish, so I really related to my father. When my dad passed, I lost my best friend. There was so much I wanted to do with him, and so much I wanted to see.
Your father made me feel like that you feel like that your new husband is like your dad, or like I feel like this.
He is my dad.
And he says, he said, it's okay if your husband becomes your new best friend.
For my dad to acknowledge that my husband is my best friend, it's, I don't know how to say it other than it's poetic. Even as a little girl, I knew that I wanted to grow up someday and marry a man that was just like my dad. And I was so lucky and fortunate that when I found my husband that I did, I found my best friend.
Did your husband want to be here?
Yes.
This is your father. This is your father. I told you, you should have let him come. Your father?
Yeah.
Very funny.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. Quick in, out, just commentary.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah.
So now, did you try to obtain things from your parents and you weren't able to?
I tried to save as much stuff as I could.
They talk about a ring. There's like one ring. Do you have the ring?
I have my father's ring.
Oh.
Yeah.
Because he showed it to me like a pinky ring, so that's just, it doesn't have to
be. It fits me as a pinky ring.
Perfect.
That's the only finger it fits on.
So knowing that you really tried
to
save everything.
Yeah.
But what really no one can ever take from you is what's here within your soul.
Yeah.
Now, were you young when your mom departed?
Yeah.
This is important because your mom made me feel like this heaviness and like a blocking of emotions and worry. Do you worry about getting sick? Because she just said to me, tell her to stop worrying.
When Theresa was talking about Kim worrying about everything, she was spot on. My mother was first diagnosed with breast cancer when we were at a very young age.
I worry about my health. I'm very vigilant, probably hyper-vigilant about my health because of it. My mom's cancer really impacted my life. I understood at a young age mortality. Most children would call home to see if their mom had made cookies. I would call home at lunch to see if my mother was still alive.
Your mother says, I don't want anyone to ever feel that I could have been saved. She says, you're always so happy, but yet you have this spot in your soul that is so angry. And that you feel that she should have been saved and could have been saved. And that you even went on some type of rant after she died. Because she shows me you looking through like reports and medical reports and whatever it is and going down. How could not know, anybody know?
The last part was misdiagnosed, yeah. My mother's breast cancer metastasized into bone cancer, which was misdiagnosed as tendonitis. When I found out that it was cancer and that there's something we could have done earlier, it made me very angry.
Mike has a lot of unresolved issues about that and a lot of sadness and anger, and he's been wanting to heal that.
Your mom says, I want you to know that I have to take some of the responsibility. Because she made me feel like she didn't realize that she was sick.
She never acted like it, too.
No.
She says, but I died on my terms, and I would not have had it any other way.
She did, yeah. Too. She always said she wanted to see us through high school, and she did.
Your parents don't separate. So when souls don't separate, it means the information comes from both of them.
Okay?
I felt like I'm not really conscious. But it's almost like I opened my eyes, saw you, closed my eyes, and then I took my last breath.
Yeah, specifically with our mother, she was somewhat interactive for 2 seconds, and then it was over. She left.
They want you to know, and this is so unusual because it's both of your parents, and it's the same exact thing that happened, that was our last gift to you.
Yeah. Wow.
She says, and I want to thank you for giving me peace at the end of my life. She said, it was time for me to depart, and I don't want you to feel bad about that.
Our mother and father passed about a year and a half apart. While my mother was battling with the bone cancer, we found out my father had a brain tumor.
This brain tumor caused a stroke to give him paralysis. It was very difficult to see. It was so close to the death of our mother, it didn't seem real. It almost seemed like a sick joke.
Do you still have the book of hers with her handwriting in it?
Her journal. Okay.
And do you see the pages that I write? How proud I am of my children. She says, I want to thank you for treasuring that journal. And she actually showed me you writing in the journal and writing the end and then crossed it out and wrote, it's never the end. She says, I want you to write the end of my journal today. She says, I want you to be able to write that we know of all of the milestones and that even though we physically weren't here, our souls will never leave you.
Wow. After the experience, I feel, I don't know, recharged, exhilarated, excited, you know, to be able to have some of the things that you question and wonder and have them validated is very freeing.
If you wonder if your parents know of who you are and who you've become, the first thing they said was that they wanted to thank him for doing this for me today.
Yeah. Thank you.
So this was awesome.
Thank you so much.
Watching them listen to Theresa felt so rewarding. It felt really, you know, satisfying. This experience with Theresa is one that I will never, ever forget.